Hi, good morning one and all. I would like to thank the chair and the organizers for providing us this opportunity to discuss the work that we have done back in Ireland. So first up, if you take a look into the tapered fiber sensors, so they take up the entire bandwidth of the optical light source that you are using it to illuminate it. A key thing to be considered is when a sensor takes up the entire band of the illuminating light, interrogating more than one sensor simultaneously becomes a challenge. So our work demonstrates the interrogation of multiple tapered sensors, which basically take up the entire bandwidth of the source in a single interferometric scan. So today in this talk, I'll give a brief introduction to sensors and sensing techniques and the typical tapered sensor interrogation methods, and then run through the experiment, our experimental setup, the results with that that we obtained, and then finally summarize everything. So first up, this is the basic structure of a tapered sensor. So it is an optical fiber with a section of reduced diameter. So we have a section of down taper section, the waist region, and then the up taper section. So when the sensor is illuminated with the light, theoretically we have two modes combining together, and practically we'll have basically more than one modes. So the expression that you see gives the intensity of the light being transmitted, where ICO stands for the intensity of the core mode and CL stands for the cladding mode, and the cos phi is the phase difference between the two modes over here. And by continuously monitoring the coupling efficiency or the phase difference between the two modes, we can actually monitor the environment surrounding the tapered sensor. So in basic studies where the medium or the environment surrounding the tapered sensor's refractive index is considerably lesser than that of the fiber or cladding, say basically like an air or something, the use of spectral interference of the tapered sensor the spectral interference of the tapered sensor is made used, and the change in phase of the spectral fringes is monitored for studying the environment. So, but in cases where you need to use the sensor in a liquid environment where the refractive index of the medium is almost close to that of the cladding, the fringe visibility reduces, and then the interrogation becomes a challenge. The interrogation by the phase difference becomes a challenge. And in those cases, we can use the temporal fringes of the interferometer of the, the temporal fringes of the interferograms transmitted by the tapered sensor for interrogation purposes. So the previous person had already given some brief introduction to the FPGs. So in any temporal scanned interferometric, temporally scanned interferometer setup, we need to do the delay calibration either by using a zero crossing detectors or by using a high coherent laser. So in our case, we are using a fiber Bragg grating for the referencing purposes. So just like how the previous person shot, when you illuminate a fiber Bragg grating, a narrow band of light gets reflected. So this FPG is dependent on a number of different physical parameters like strain, temperature, pressure, etc. So there are two components to the temperature depend the light wavelength of light reflected by the FPG: the coefficient of thermal expansion part, and then the coefficient of elasticity, which is strain dependent. And so by stabilizing the fiber Bragg grating in a fiber oven, we can obtain a stable wavelength source reflected by the fiber Bragg grating, and hence we are using the FPGs for referencing purposes for delay calibration. So looking into the conventional or a typical tapered sensor interrogation techniques, so first the sensor is being illuminated with a broadband source, and then either OSA is used, a spectrometer or an optical power meter is used. So with the existing setup or the typical interrogation schemes, we cannot interrogate more than one tapered sensor at a time, as I mentioned earlier. And if you are using a OSA or an optical power meter, like I mentioned before, in a liquid environment, the fringe visibility reduces and you don't have the temporal fringes if you are using an OSA for the interrogation. So the interrogation of the tapered sensor itself becomes a challenge in a liquid environment if you are using an OSA. So this study, what we have done, is an attempt to address both these limitations. So this is our experimental setup. We have an all-fiber Michelson interferometer illuminated with a broadband source through a circulator. And we have used isolators at each and every stage in order to prevent any back reflections. And we have used Faraday rotor mirrors at the end in the Michelson interferometer to reduce polarization induced fading. So some of you might pull me and ask me as to why I have used a fiber Bragg grating when I can get a far more high resolution measurements using a high coherent laser. So by using an FPG, what we have actually done is we have made use of both the arms of the interferometer. This is a Michelson interferometer. So by using a FPG, we have made use of both the arms. And again, the other arm can be expanded just like this by the addition of couplers and isolators. So if we use a laser, basically the second arm will be confined only for the referencing purposes. So that is the reason for using a FPG for referencing. And the delay generated by the piezo fiber stretcher is approximately 13 millimeters when modulated by a 1 hertz sine wave. So according to the manufacturer guidelines, the delay or the OPD changes logarithmically with increasing frequencies. So that is why we fix the frequency at approximately 1 hertz. And on a single interferometric scan, we got this is the low coherence interferogram of the optical source that we used, the 1550 nanometer broadband source. And this is the interferogram reflected by the FPGs and the other two interferograms transmitted through the tapered sensors. So let me just quickly move over to the previous slide. So in a conventional interrogation schemes, what we will have the set, we have the source, the fiber, and then the interrogation unit. So in conventional interrogation systems, what you will have is you'll have the source first, the fiber next, and then the interferometer or the interrogator. But in our case, we have switched the order. We have the interrogator first, the sensor, and then the photo detectors. So what we are actually doing is instead of using the light and then generating the interferograms, we are generating the interferograms and then using them to study the different sensors. So this actually enables us to use, this is the reason the switch allowed us to use a number of different arrays of sensors. So the first two graphs or the plots are the uncalibrated spectra from the readings. And upon delay calibration using the fiber Bragg gratings, you can see that all the spectra has been cleaned up well. So we used two tapered sensors. One had a larger FSR and another one had a smaller FSR. And like I mentioned before, if the medium that is to be monitored has a refractive index much lesser than that of the cladding, then you can use these fringes for monitoring the phase shifts. But if the medium is a liquid or if the medium's refractive index is close to that of the cladding, then this fringe visibility reduces and we need to use the temporal interferograms. And in our studies, we use these interferograms for quantifying the measure and parameters. So in order to validate the system, different concentrations of glucose solutions were prepared by serial dilution. And the sensors were placed in a bath, and these solutions were sequentially added, and scans taken after the addition of each and every set of the solution. And as you can see from these plots, these are the ratios between the temporal phase vectors of the tapered sensors versus the FPGs. Linear fit was made to the entire data set to show a positive change for increasing concentrations. And upon the use of a piezo fiber stretcher, we have two interferograms generated per scan. That is, like, one is due to the stretching of the fiber and another is due to the relaxation of the fiber. So the relaxation of the piezo fiber stretcher is non-uniform. So we neglected those readings and we considered only the stretching part of the interferograms. And each data log has 10 sets of samples. So basically 20 interferograms were reduced to 10. And these are the points that you see over here for the two tapered sensors. And we took a median of the entire data set. Say, for example, for the first concentration change, we had 10 sets of data. And we took a median of it and then plotted them over here. And this is the theoretical variation of the glucose solutions that we added. And this is the data that was picked up or the deciphered using the tapered sensor. So let me just quickly go back to the concentration table over here. As you can see here, the change is approximately about 1.6% between the second and the third glucose solution addition. So if we go into this plot over here, you can clearly see the 1.66% glucose change picked up by the tapered sensor. That is how efficient or sensitive our sensor is. So upon fitting the linear slope to the data plotted, we got the linear resolutions as seen or as given here. So any solution that you prepare by serial dilution will have a cubic nature in addition to it. So that is what we have demonstrated in the theoretical plot as well as in our tapered sensor plot over here. So if we confine the data set to a lesser number of data, you can actually have a linear fit done to the data sets. So to summarize, we just demonstrated the interrogation of more than one tapered sensor in a single interferometric scan. And we made use of the temporal fringes to decipher the data picked up by the tapered sensors. And this makes the monitoring of even liquid environments feasible with the tapered sensor. And finally, the results that we obtained from the tapered sensor were found to be in concurrence with the theoretical values. Thank you.
Thank you.